Hi, good evening.
Good evening, teacher.
How are you, Saul?
Good.
Okay, excellent. And what happened to you yesterday?
He tenido una tarde mero ajetreada ahora.
Ay, me imagino. You're not the only one.
Y mire cómo ando la cara. Rojo,
oh,
rojo.
Yeah. Did you go to the beach?
Not working in the calle.
Oh, on the street?
In the street, vendor in medical supply.
Ah, okay. Mm-hmm. So are you a salesperson?
Clinic. Doctor, hospital.
Ah, okay. I see. Excellent. But yes, I can see that you look really, really burned. Here on your forehead, I can see it. Yes.
Good evening.
Hi, good evening, Stephanie. How are you?
I'm fine. Thank you for asking.
Good evening.
Hello. Hi, good evening, Jocelyn. Good evening, Lily. I really like your felt of toys, Stephanie. Aquí le estamos viendo los peluchitos.
Sí, yo tengo tres.
Yeah, okay.
It's too cute.
Yo yeah, me voy a acercar cute. Para que solo me miren a mí.
No, that's okay. I mean, that's not a problem. I have one here next to me too, so you can see it. Yeah, but that is my baby. Well, it's not my baby's, but he loves it.
Good evening, teacher.
Hi, good evening, Janet. How are you?
More or less.
Wow, what happened to you?
I'm sick.
Ah, you're sick?
Sí.
¿Aún sigue enferma?
Todavía, ando con dolor de cabeza. Ahí, la presión alta.
Y el domingo dijo que había ido a pasar consulta, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Ok, ya. Yeah.
Todavía estamos en eso, pero aquí estamos.
Ok. Yes, so I hope that you can get better soon. I have my baby that is a little bit sick too. That's why he was crying a lot yesterday, and believe me that I'm sorry for that. But now I think that he's kind of better. And that's really good. Okay, today we are going to begin with section number 3 on the platform. But before that, I need you to tell me if you have questions for sections 1 and 2.
No.
No questions?
No question.
Okay. Okay, no era problem. Vamos a iniciar entonces con la que es la sección número 3. Okay? And we are going to begin with a short conversation that we have on the platform. So we're going to listen, and then we are going to be practicing, okay? Let me know if you can listen, please. So here we go.
Welcome everybody to section 8. What's your neighborhood like? As we always do, we listen to a conversation in order to get ready for our topics, which will include places around town, location, and there are.
In this session, you will listen to a conversation between neighbors asking about places in town. Pay attention to there is, there are, one, any, and some.
Excuse me, I'm your new neighbor, Jack. I just moved in.
Oh, yes?
I'm looking for a grocery store. Are there any around here?
Yes, there are some on Pine Street.
Oh, good. And is there a laundromat near here?
Well, I think there's one across from the shopping center.
Thank you.
By the way, there's a barber shop in the shopping center, too.
A barber shop?
Okay, that's the conversation that we had.
There are some on...
Kind of funny, honestly. So let's see. Do I have volunteer for this conversation to practice it?
Me, teacher.
Thank you, Jocelyn Larin. And whom else?
Me, teacher.
Thank you, Janet. Let's begin.
Okay.
Okay. Excuse me. I'm your new neighbor. Jack, I just moved in.
Oh, yes.
I'm looking for a grocery store. Are there any around here?
Yes, there are some on Pine Street.
Oh, good. And is there a laundromat? Como?
Yes, laundromat. That is correct.
Mm-hmm. Laundromat near here?
Well, I seen there once across from the shopping center.
Thank you.
By the way, there's a barber shop in the shopping center too.
A barber shop?
Okay, yes. Excellent. Thank you. Okay. Let's see, who's next?
Edwin.
Okay, so we have Edwin and?
Wait, Saul.
And Saul, thank you.
Okay. Excuse me, I'm your new neighbor, Jack, and just moving in.
Oh, yes.
I'm looking for a grocery store. Are there any around here?
Yes, there are some on Pine Street.
Oh, good. Is there a laundromat near here?
Well, I think there one across from the shopping center.
Thank you.
By the way, there a barber shop in the shopping center too?
A barber shop?
Okay, excellent. Who's next? Let's see.
Let me see.
Okay.
Lilian.
Okay, Guevara. Lilian. And whom else?
Abigail Portillo.
Okay, thank you. So we have Lily and Abigail.
Excuse me, I'm your new neighbor, Jack. I just moved in.
Oh, yes.
I'm looking for a grocery store. Are there any around here?
Yes, there are some on Pine Street.
Oh, good. And is there a laundromat near here?
Well, I think there's one across from the shopping center.
Thank you.
By the way, there's a barber shop in the shopping center too.
A barber shop?
Okay, excellent. And the last two people?
Walter Rivera.
Okay, so we have Walter and
Esperanza.
Okay. You said Walter Rivera and Esmeralda?
Esperanza.
Ah, Esperanza. Thank you.
Yes.
No, that's okay. We're practicing the conversation.
Okay.
Okay, but let me see. Esperanza, can you hear us? Esperanza? Okay, so I think that she is having some problems. Can you choose another person, please?
Monica.
Monica. Okay, thank you. So we're going to have Walter and Monica.
Okay. Ready, Monica?
Yes.
Okay. Excuse me, I am your little neighbor, Jack. I just moved in.
Oh, yeah?
I am looking for a grocery store. Are there any around here?
Yes, there are some on Pine Street.
Oh, good. And is there a laundromat near here?
Well, I think there's one across from the shopping.
Thank you.
By the way, there's a barber shop in the shopping center too.
A barber shop?
Okay, excellent. So now it's time for feedback, okay? Some of you read these like movies, something like that. But let me explain to you that when we have, for example, words that end in a consonant and the next one begin with a vowel, what we can do is link sounds. Podemos unir los sonidos. So instead of saying moved in, we can say moved in. Yeah, you can see that the D and the I join, so we have a new sound, moved in. Okay. Okay, another one. How do you pronounce these?
Yes.
Yes. Yeah. Yes or yes?
Oh, yes. Yes, por lo general.
Yeah.
Yes.
But the pronunciation is yes. Okay, the correct pronunciation is yes. Because you said, oh, yes, or... Oh yes, algo así se les escucha. Oh yes, like in Spanish, and no, okay? Oh yes, yes. If you can see here,
yes,
this is a question. So intonation is important. Oh yes, like uh-huh, for example. Okay, let me see, this one. I could see that some of you had problems.
Yes.
How do you pronounce it?
Laundromat.
Okay, excellent. Laundromat. Okay. Okay. Those were the only words that I could listen or that I could identify. Do you have questions?
No.
Sorry, teacher.
Uh-huh.
What's the meaning of laundromat?
Lavandería.
Lavandería.
Oh.
Yes. Here in our country, they are becoming popular. Yes.
No, starting.
Another question?
No.
No? Okay. Okay, so not a problem. There's something else that we are going to be studying right now. And this is about there is and there are. Also, we are going to remember, or we're going to practice, prepositions of place. Which prepositions of place do you remember? Can you tell me?
Preposition?
Of place.
Wow.
Of place.
Place.
Yes?
One. Any sound?
There are?
No. Near?
Okay, near.
Under.
Under.
Next, no.
Next to.
Next.
Across from.
Across from, okay.
Between.
Between.
On the corner of.
On the corner of, okay. Corner. Excellent. Excellent, so I can see you remember.
Above.
Above, okay. Perfect, so that's something that we are going to be studying because I have a map for you that is the same we have on the platform and we are going to be practicing, okay? So we're going to watch the video right now that we have there and then we will be practicing with a map, okay? So this is the video. Just pay attention. And let me know if you can listen.
Welcome back to another session. This time, we'll learn to ask if there is or not a particular place in town. We'll go over prepositions of place, which will help us give directions.
In this session, participants will learn how to ask and answer questions with there is, there are, one, any, and some.
There is, there are. One, any, some.
Is there a laundromat near here?
Yes, there is. There's one across from the shopping center.
No, there isn't. But there's one next to the library. Are there any grocery stores around here?
Yes, there are. There are some nice stores on Pine Street.
No, there aren't. But there are some on Third Avenue. No, there aren't any around here.
Prepositions.
On. Next to. Near. Close to. Across from. Opposite. In front of. In back of. Behind. Between. On the corner of.
If you want to know if there is a place near you, we do it by saying, is there a near here? Of course, the answer will depend on if there is or not. You may answer yes, there is, or no, there isn't. If your answer is yes, there is, you may continue by saying, yes, there is. There's one next to the gas station. Prepositions of place. Let's go over the prepositions by looking at the map. The post office is on Main Street. The gas station is next to the public library. The shopping center is close or near the public library. The telephone booth is across from the gas station. The plaza is in front of the post office. The electronics store is behind or the back of the post office. The plaza is between First National Bank and the grocery store. The gas station is on the corner of First Avenue. Make sure you practice and understand each preposition of place.
Okay.
Across.
So we're going to begin here with there is, there are, one, any, and some. So, Susan, can you read the first information, this information, please?
Yes. Is there a
laundromat?
A laundromat near here? Yes, there is. There's one across from the shopping center? No, there isn't, but there's one next to the library.
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 Thank you. Stephanie, continue, please.
Okay. Are there any grocery stores around here? Yes, there are. There are some nice stores on Pine Street. No, there aren't. But there are some on the Third Avenue. No, there aren't any around here.
Thank you. Okay, let's continue. Let me see. Delia, can you read the prepositions, please? Delia? Okay, sorry, Delia, but we cannot hear you. Okay, Ale, can you read the prepositions, please?
¿Cuáles? Porque me acabo de conectar y...
These.
Okay. Wait. On, next to, near, close to, across from, opposite, in front of, in back of, behind, between,
okay,
on the corner of.
Excellent. On the corner of. Perfect. So you can see here that we have these two questions that we are going to be using in a few minutes. The first one says, is there a laundromat near here? Are there any grocery stores around here? So you can see here that we are using is there and here are there. Okay, so what's the difference? Can anyone?
Singular.
Okay, plural. Singular and plural. And what do they mean in Spanish?
Hay una lavandería cerca.
Okay, hay. Hay, de haber, ¿verdad? Okay, thank you. And as Walter said, the difference basically is that here we're talking in singular and here we're talking in plural. Okay, so with prepositions, we have on, next to, near, close to, across from, opposite, in front of, in back of, or behind, between, and on the corner of. Okay, do you remember all these
prepositions? Teacher,
yes,
teacher, sorry, ¿a qué se refiere con on the corner of?
On the corner of. Déjenme, ¿logran ver el mapa?
En la esquina de.
Okay, thank you. But do you see my map?
No.
No, you cannot see it. Okay. So let me just share it. It's the same that we just watched on the video, right? So you can see I have my map here. So if I want to say, or if I want to use the preposition on the corner of, so for example, I can talk about the gas station.
Gas station.
Okay, yes, you see it here. Let me check. Okay, so I have here the gas station. And you can tell me that the gas station is on the corner of, let me choose another color. Okay, you can tell me that the gas station is on the corner of, ¿en la esquina de dónde está?
First Avenue, and Main Street.
Excellent, perfect. So you can see here that the gas station is on the corner of First Avenue and Main Street. Okay. So what if I want to ask about? Let me see. Mom and Pop's Grocery. We have it here. Where is it?
In the corner of Second Avenue and Main Street.
Pine Street. Ah, okay, perfect. So you see, ahí es donde estoy usando on the corner of, en la esquina de. Okay?
Okay.
Another question? So what if I ask?
Teacher, thanks.
You're welcome. What if I ask, where is Joe's gym?
Between post office and other department store.
Excellent. So you can see that Joe's gym is between the post office and O'Day department store. And where is Prince grocery store?
Mom's Pop grocery store, Second Avenue.
Between the bank?
Between the bank?
Next to.
Ah, okay,
the
excellent.
First National Bank.
Perfect. It is next to First National Bank. Excellent. So this is the map that we are going to be using and the one that we are going to be working with in a few minutes. Okay? But what we are going to do is the following. Okay? So we have here the prepositions of place that we are going to be using. We're going to use there is and there are. You can also use one, any, and some. Okay, but the way that you are going to be using all of them is the following. So, for example, we have the question, is there a near here? So, for example, if I ask, is there a bank near here? Okay, let me... Okay, now here it is. So I ask, is there a bank? Let's suppose that, let me just get here. Let's suppose that, I can find the, where is it? Okay, so here it is. So let's suppose that I'm here at O'Day's department store and I'm asking, is there a bank near here? What would you say?
No, there are.
No, there is.
No, there is. Yes, yes.
No,
yes.
There
is. There is.
There
isn't.
There isn't. Okay. And what can you tell me? Digamos que me he perdido y necesito un banco con urgencia. And I'm here.
The bank is next to Princess Grocery Store in First Avenue.
Okay.
También the bank is in front of the place, or la plaza.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Usando el ejemplo ahí, le decía ya, but there is one bank. From King Place Hotel.
Excellent. So let me just share it with you. Perfect. Okay, so you can see that here we have these. Is there a bank near here? You can tell me, yes, there is, or no, there isn't. In the case that I really need it, you can tell me, no, there isn't, but, you're using the conjunction, but there is one. And then you can say on Pine Street or on Main Street next to the gas station. Here we have, yes, there is one next to the gas station. So let me show you the other one that we have. I remember that we had another. Okay, so I don't see it. Okay, but as your classmate was saying, you can say no, there aren't, but there are some, or there is one next to the library, or there is one on Main Street, for example. Okay? Is that clear for you? ¿Está claro?
Yes.
Clear.
Okay. So, I'm going to share again with you the map. So, this is the map that we are going to be using. We're going to be working in breakout rooms. Vamos a trabajar en grupos, ¿verdad? And I need you to tell me the place that you are going to be in. Necesito que me digan en qué lugar van a estar y que hagan preguntas. For example, is there a drugstore near here? Yes.
Post office.
Bueno, no está cerca, está un poco.
I'm asking you about a drugstore. Is there a drugstore near here?
Yes.
Yes, what?
Yes, there is.
Yes, there is.
And where is it?
Yes, there is.
¿Y dónde está?
Between the Tuxedos, Mount's Pop Grocery.
Okay, excellent. So, I need you to work on that, okay? Eso es lo que necesito que hagan ahorita. Ustedes pueden decir, so, for example, I'm on the telephone booth, sorry. En la cabina de teléfono me pueden decir, I'm here. And you can ask, where is, or is there a hotel near here? And then you can say, yes, there is, or no, there isn't, or... Yes, there are. No, there aren't. Is that clear?
Yes.
Okay. So, let's begin working. Okay, so here we go.
I don't know. ¿Qué podemos hacer?
Hay que decidir algún lugar, teacher, donde vamos a encontrarnos en teoría o solo hacer preguntas relacionadas a.
Okay, you can decide that because if you notice, we have the map. So that would be easier for you to make the examples. So let me share the map with you.
Okay.
Okay, so here we have it. So for example, you can say, okay, we're going to be at the gas station, okay? So you can stay here. And then you can start making questions. Or you can say, we are on the public library. Okay, and we want to go, for example, to the restaurant, for example. Okay.
Okay. But yo no entendí. Es como para llegar hacia el restaurante.
Okay, van a preguntar si hay un restaurante. Is there a restaurant near here? And you can say, yes, there is, or no, there isn't. Y luego le dicen dónde está. Si está a la par o en medio, across from, y todo eso.
Okay, is, for example, is there a gas station by así?
Okay, sorry, can you make the question one more time?
Is there a gas station on Pine Avenue?
Okay. And what would you answer?
No, there isn't.
Okay, and then?
Is one
there is
Pierce Avenue.
there is one
uh-huh. And next to public library,
next to the public library, or as you were saying, on First Avenue.
Okay.
Or you can also use on the corner of First Avenue and Main Street, okay? Sí, okay. Vamos a, primero necesito que digan en qué lugar van a estar, ¿verdad? Para que ese sea su punto de referencia y luego pregunten si hay o no hay. De ser así, que también igualmente se digan dónde está, usando las preposiciones del lugar, ¿ok?
Okay, teacher, thanks.
You're welcome. Any other question?
No.
Okay, so thank you.
The corner of.
Ajá, corner of. No lo escuché eso.
Ajá, sí, pero se lo dije. Y le dije la las calles. The First Avenue. The First Avenue on Main Street.
Okay.
Yes. Near the telephone.
All right, next.
Is there a hotel? Esperanza.
I don't have the mat for that. I don't say.
You can see it?
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
Sorry. Okay.
The gas station, there is the corner of First Avenue.
Yes.
Okay, but what was the question? Sorry.
There are a gas station.
Is there a gas station? Okay.
Mm-hmm. They are here.
It is on the corner of streets, maybe.
Yes.
First Avenue, Main Street. Por ahí estamos, ¿verdad, teacher?
Ok.
Yes. Yes, yes.
Right. Okay, so I'm listening to you.
Is there public library?
Is there a public library? ¿Y dónde se encuentra Esperanza, digamos? No, usted digamos que dónde se encontraba.
In the front of the National Bank.
Where is the bank?
She said that she is on First National Bank. Ella dice que está acá. Okay, and she is asking if there is a public library.
Across from Kim Plus Hotel.
Oh yes, the public library is next to the station.
Ah, okay. Okay.
Near Prince Grocery Store.
No, wait. Ella dice que está acá. Ella dice que está en el First National Bank. Y está preguntando por the public library. Okay. Vaya, primero tienen que ubicarse ustedes en el mapa. Vaya, y decía ahí la compañera que ya está en el National Bank. Y quiere saber si hay una public library. Y ustedes le dicen si sí o si no. Y de ser sí, ¿dónde está? Decía ahí el compañero. It is next to the gas station. Okay.
Okay.
Ahora bien, Walter. Where are you? On this map. En este mapa, ¿dónde se encuentra usted?
I am at Joe's Gym.
Ah, so you are at Joe's Gym. Okay, thank you. So aquí tenemos a Walter. Okay.
Post office.
Janet, you are in the post office, or where are you?
Where are you?
Uh-huh.
Post office.
Ok, vaya. Entonces tenemos que Esperanza está en el First National Bank, usted está acá en el Post Office y Walter está en el gimnasio, Joe's Gym, ok. Ya estando ustedes ubicados en esos lugares pueden preguntar dónde queda, por ejemplo, Rosa's Restaurant o The Top Shoes, ya ustedes se van a ir ubicando, ok.
Okay.
Okay.
Perfect.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you,
teacher.
Okay.
Walter.
Hello, good evening, teacher. Sorry, I don't know the no pude entrar a la reunión porque acabo de terminar la reunión de trabajo. Hello.
Sorry. Lo siento, sorry. Pensé que me había quitado el silencio. Okay. That's okay. Right now we are working in groups. Estamos trabajando en grupos. La voy a asignar a uno de ellos.
Okay, sorry. Estaba tratando de, estaba escuchando la clase y estaba con la reunión. Sorry. Días ingratos.
No, that's okay.
Y que trabajo con cursos del INSAFOR y con Plan Internacional. El problema es de que ahorita estamos en una jornada de capacitación de recursos virtuales y nos tienen así súper apretados con el diseño de contenidos y casi que a diario nos reunimos, tenemos las reuniones, por eso a veces entro y no entro porque estoy en una reunión y en la otra, así que lo siento.
No, that's okay. I totally understand you because I'm basically doing the same. I'm multitasking. O sea, yo también estoy así que en varias cosas. Estoy sacando un diplomado. Estoy con mis clases. Tengo clases presenciales también. Estoy con mi chiquitín, que ahorita está un poquito enfermo. Entonces ando en varias cosas. Así que no se preocupen. La comprendo a la perfección.
Okay, teacher, perfect. Thank you for the comprehension.
Comprehension.
Comprehension. Okay, it's not easy or study every day. Estoy igual con mi maestría. Estoy con posgrado. Perdón, acabo de terminar el posgrado y ya estoy con la maestría. Llevo unos cursos de la OIT, de recursos virtuales, y eso comentaba con una compañera, ya no más cursos, pero es como una, no, ¿cómo decirlo? Es una manía de seguirnos capacitando. De hecho, esto sí. Es una, nosotros como consultores o como facilitadores, es algo de ley que tenemos que estar en constante capacitación, y hay que... Okay, teacher. Gracias.
Yeah. Sí, mire, no se preocupe que como usted lo ha dicho, como facilitadores nos toca estarnos actualizando prácticamente año con año. Entonces, la entiendo. Vaya, la voy a unir a una sesión de grupo pequeño para que esté ahí trabajando con sus compañeros, ¿ok?
Ok, perfecto.
Thank you.
Perfecto.
Calle, porque la entrada está aquí de este lado.
Yes, pero de.
O sea que sería que está en
Elm Street.
And Elm Street.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Or no.
In Pine Street, front Frank y Coffee.
Near.
Near.
cross left on Second Avenue. Una vez, ¿cómo se dice una vez? Ay, sí. On Pine Street. Oh, I don't know.
Ajá, I'm just listening to you. What are you doing?
¿Qué estamos?
Queremos llegar de acá a Jameson Hotel.
Ah. Okay, so what was the question that you asked?
Who can tell me? Is there a Jameson or Hotel?
Hotel, or okay.
Hotel.
No, what you can do is to ask where is...
Oh, hotel.
You can ask where there. Is Jameson Hotel.
Yeah.
And they can tell you it is next to Frank's Cafe or it is on...
Behind. Rose Restaurant.
Okay, Rose's Restaurant. Okay.
Y para and decir across. sobre, porque nosotros hemos acostumbrado sobre la calle.
On. Yes.
Okay. On Elm Street.
Okay.
Across quiero ver cómo se puede decir. Front of the Moms and Pops grocery.
Behind.
No. Enfrente de.
Is it in front of?
Front of.
O aquí se podría decir across the street.
Okay, across from.
Across. From the street.
No, okay. Si están diciendo que está sobre la calle Elm, you can say on Elm Street, next to, dando un poco más de referencia, next to
Frank's
Cafe. Frank's Excellent. Cafe.
Okay.
Okay. Thanks.
You're welcome. Yes.
Your turn, Saul.
No, yo no veía bien también, no se preocupe.
Sí.
Okay. Pero ahí sí ya veo un poco mejor las letras. Solo de un par de cosas no la veo bien.
Okay. Okay. Is there a post office near here?
Is there? Yes, there is. Is the on the corner of Main Street and First Avenue. Okay. Bueno, vamos entonces a empezar otra vez.
Hola.
Are there any? ¿Me escuchas? Sí, vea.
Sí, ahorita sí.
Ah, vale. Entonces vamos a empezar otra vez, te decía. Are there any?
Okay, so I was listening to you practicing and I could see that you're doing a really great job. Excellent. So now I just need you to share what you were talking with your classmates. So tell me, do I have volunteers?
Me, teacher.
Thank you. So let's begin.
I'm begin with a question or my ubication.
Okay, let's begin with your location, please.
Okay. Stay next to the Jamison Hotel.
So you're next to Jamison Hotel here, right?
Yes.
Okay. So let's listen to your examples.
¿Cómo se decía? What do you say? In a corner of Maple Avenue and Pine Street.
on the corner of
Maple Avenue and Pine Street.
Okay, so this is Maple Avenue and this is Pine Street. Is it here?
Yes.
Okay. And what is the place that you're looking for? Sorry.
In a Rosa restaurant.
Okay. Who were you working with, Jocelyn? ¿Con quiénes estuvo trabajando?
Susan and Abby.
Okay, so let's listen to the three of you. You can make a question to any of them, to Susan or Abby. And I'm going to try to see if I can get to the place that you're talking about. Okay?
Okay. Susan.
Yes.
Where are you?
Oh, in King Plaza Hotel.
Okay, so you are
is front of the M Street.
I'm sorry, can you repeat that answer one more time?
Okay, in front of M Street.
Okay, it is in front of or it is on?
Oh, yes. It's on M Street.
Okay, Elm Street. Thank you.
Elm.
Yes.
Okay. And I can other question.
Yes, please make another question.
Who else? Susan or Abby?
Ask to Abby, please.
Okay. And where are you, Abby?
Let me see, gas station.
Okay.
Is above to National Bank.
Above? Or behind?
No. Is yes, sorry. It's behind to National Bank.
Okay. Yes. You're not going to use two.
Is there next to the public library?
Okay, yes, you can say it's next to the public library, but when you are using the preposition behind, that's the only one. Okay, you cannot say behind two. Okay, it's behind, for example, First National Bank. Okay, so Jocelyn, can you tell me, is there a Top Shoes store near here?
No.
No what?
It's too alone. No, there isn't.
There is.
Ah, okay. No, there isn't. Can you tell me if there is a gym near here?
No.
No what? Uh-huh. No, there isn't. Okay, so let's suppose that I'm here at First National Bank. Okay, let's suppose that I'm here. Is there a public library near here?
Yes, there is.
Uh-huh. And where is it?
It's what do you say, teacher? I don't know.
Where is it?
Bank.
It's next to the public library.
Next, no, yeah. I'm looking for the public library. Yo estoy buscando ese lugar. So where is it?
There is one next to the gas station.
Okay, thank you. It is next to the gas station. Thank you. So let's see another group.
I got lost.
You got lost?
Yes.
Why?
I don't know. Con que me pierdo aquí en San Salvador.
Me too, so don't worry about it. So if you're lost and you see me, please don't ask me because we're going to get lost together, so don't do it. Okay, so let's listen to Edwin's group.
Okay. I work with Saul and Stephanie.
Okay.
And I stayed from First National Bank.
Okay.
And
so you were here?
Yes.
Okay.
Is there a Joe's gym near here?
And the question goes to
Joe's gym.
Yeah, but the question goes to whom? ¿A quién le está haciendo la pregunta?
My co-workers, Stephanie and Saul.
Okay. Stephanie, can you tell us where is the gym?
Well, the First National Bank is no, there isn't. The Joyce gym. Mm-hmm.
Okay, Edwin, can you make the question one more time, please?
Is there a Joyce gym near here?
Okay.
No.
No, what?
It isn't.
No, there isn't. Okay. Nice. But. Pero,
but Joyce Jeans is there and on my street between post office or Day's department store.
Okay, thank you. Okay, you can say no, there isn't, but there is one on Main Street between Day's department store and the post office. Okay, excellent. Edwin, make another question to Saul.
Okay. Please, is there Top Shoes near here?
Top shoes,
yes.
Okay. ¿Hacia dónde?
Listen to the question.
First National Bank.
Yeah, he said that he is at First National Bank, él está acá, and he is asking if there is a Top Shoes store.
Um, top is Pine Street. Is Pine Street is continuous Park Drugstore?
Next to.
Next to. Parker Drugstore.
Okay, thank you. So what I can see is that you're going to have homework. Parece ser que lo voy a dejar tarea. So what are you going to do as homework? ¿Qué me van a hacer de tarea entonces? Para mañana va a ser lo primero que les voy a preguntar a cada uno de ustedes, ¿verdad? Van a hacer preguntas usando there is y there are. So for example, usando siempre ese mapa. So you can ask. Is there a bank near here? ¿Hay un banco cerca de acá? You can say, yes, there is. O pueden decir, no, there isn't. But, sorry, quiero ver, there isn't. No sé por qué me salió eso allí. There isn't, but... There is one, y ustedes dicen, usando next to, for example, next to, on, si en dado caso está en medio, between, on the corner of, usando las preposiciones de lugar, y ya ustedes dicen el otro lugar. Igual, si aquí es, yes, there is, you can say, it's next to, in front of. Ahora bien, si yo quiero preguntarles de varios lugares, are there any restaurants near here? ¿Hay algunos restaurantes cerca de acá? What is it going to be the affirmative answer? Respuesta afirmativa sería.
Yes, there are.
Negative?
No, there aren't.
Okay, no, there aren't. And then you can say, in this case, but there are some on, y ustedes dicen, usando las preposiciones del lugar, okay? Igual on the affirmative answer, yes, there are. There are some restaurants near, in front of, next to, y así sucesivamente, ¿ok? Entonces, necesito que me hagan preguntas usando there is y there are. Y en las respuestas necesito que me usen lo que son las preposiciones de lugar. Is that clear for you?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Clear.
Okay. Sorry, Janet.
Pregunta, teacher.
Ah, Lily, sí.
Sí, usted está diciendo que hagamos preguntas con there are o es are there.
Okay.
¿Por qué pasó are there?
Sí, son preguntas usando el there is y el there are. O sea, el there is y there are es la forma afirmativa, ¿verdad? Pero ya en interrogativa, is there y are there. Okay.
How many questions?
At least six. Al menos seis preguntas. Yes. Okay.
Okay.
Another question.
Okay. Thanks.
Not a problem. Otra pregunta. Okay, so if there are no questions, we're going to stop here. And don't forget to do your homework, okay?
Okay.
Okay, so that's all for today. Okay. Thank you for coming and see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
Bye.
Good night, everyone.
Thanks.
Bye-bye.